Hello, everybody. It is the Northern Ireland Science Festival. And I am Scientific Sue. And we are going to be doing some science magic. Yes, I caught it. And today, we're going to be looking at the EVANESCO spell. It's the Vanishing spell. And it was a spell that was used by Snape to make Harry Potter's potions disappear. So we are going to get a potion to disappear. And we've got a choice. We can use the elixir of life, water, or we can use unicorn's wee wee. So I think I'll use the unicorn's wee wee. Now let's have a sniff. Ooh, that's delicious. See, normal people's wee wee is horrible. But because it's unicorn, it just smells like flowers and spring days. It's gorgeous. Now, it is a science festival, so we are going to have to bring in some science. And when you're a scientist, you have to be able to be really good observing things. So I've got three cups here, and I'm going to pour the unicorn's urine into the middle cup. Sounded funny. And I'm not going to do any magic yet. I just want to check that you're able to follow what I'm doing. So what we've got here then is I'm going to move the cups around, and then you're going to shout at me which cup you think the water, the unicorn's urine, is in. Okay, ready? So I'm going to move them around. Da, 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 da. Ooh. Okay. Right, okay. Which one is it in? Yes! It's the middle one. I can make that really easy. We're going to do this time now, and we're going to do it with magic, and we're going to try to make this unicorn, oh my goodness, that's very yellow, this urine to disappear. We can use magic wands, but you can also use anything that looks like a wand whenever we're doing magic. I've got a bit of rope here. And all I have to do is think magic, and then all of a sudden it becomes like a magic rope. And then I can go, I don't want you to be magic, and then it goes back to being a rope. We can use lots of different things because we are magicians. So the whole thing about today is teaching you to become magicians. I'm going to throw that rope away. So we have our cups. I've got the unicorn's urine in here, and these cups are empty. You have to watch very carefully, but this time I've got my wand and I'm going to make a spell. EVANESCO is the spell word, and it's the word that the magicians know to mean disappear. So EVANESCO, and you can practice being really magical when you do these spells. The cup you choose this time, I'm going to pour over my head. Okay, so I hope the magic has worked. Here we go. Moving the cups around. Now, you're going to be shouting at me. You're not allowed a point. I don't want to see any pointing. And the cup that you choose, I'm going to pour over my head. So it's going to be the one on the... Well, we've got the left, we've got the right, we've got the middle. Okay, so which of these cups am I going to pick up? The cup on the right? Is that what you're saying? The cup on the right? Fantastic. I'm going to pick this cup up. It's my right. It's my right hand. And no, you're not happy with that one. Okay. You want me to pour this one over my head. Sometimes magic doesn't work. Here we go. Three, two. Oh, hang on. Wait. I need to put on my safety glasses. Any splashes at all, we have to wear safety glasses. So here we go. Three, two, one. Ah! Oh! It's gone! It's not there. It's not there. And it's not there. Is it magic? Or is it science? You've got it right. Inside here, I had some crystals hidden. And if I put my hand in, look at those crystals there, they're nice and shiny. These are the crystals that we find inside babies' nappies. And so when the babies go to the toilet, these crystals suck up all of the crystals and lock it tight inside the nappy. Now, how are you going to be able to do this spell at home? Now, we don't need big cups. So in my little sets, I'm just using 3 small little pots. But any pot that you're going to use needs to be opaque. We can't see through it. They can't know what's inside. And here, I've got some jelly bath. Any of you using that? It's absolutely disgusting. It turns your bath into a slime pit. Yes. Now, we've got a little label here, and we're going to call these crystals death eaters, because those were the nasty things. They sucked the life out of people in the Harry Potter land. So we're going to use this to suck the liquid out of our pot. So I'm going to cut that off. And we're going to save this then inside a little pot for us to use again and again. Now, this is supposed to be for one bath. Don't use it all at once. You can actually get maybe 10 baths out of this. But what we're going to do is we're not using it in a bath, we're using it for science, for magic. And I love it because it's all green and disgusting. So we're going to put 1 spoonful of this into our pot. And the lovely thing is, if you even look, you can't really see it's there. And whenever we are doing any science, we always tidy away what we're not using. We've got our unicorn's urine. We've got our wand. And now you can do the same spell. But this time, when you're in front of the family or your friends or in your classroom, you can say you're going to pour it over somebody else's head. Don't pour it over yours. And we're going to pour the unicorn's urine into the middle cup. There it goes. And then when you move the cups around, always end up with it back in the middle, because that means everybody is going to be able to say the middle. It's a very easy answer. And once you then lift it up, you can then pour it on top of the crystals that you know are there. Nobody else knows they're there. You've put them in before anyone arrived in the room. It takes a little time for these crystals to do their work. So this is why we then start to move it around. And you've got to tell them to keep their eye on the cup. And while you're moving them around, you're going to start to see the shininess of the water disappear. And we're going to end up having it sucked into these jelly bath crystals. Do you remember the name of the spell? Doesn't matter, because we have a spell book for you. You're going to go onto the Northern Ireland Science Festival website and you can download it and you can learn all of the spells. So this one is the Vanishing spell, the EVANESCO spell. And we have to be very, use our arms, EVANESCO. And you can wear a hat if you want. You can put white gloves on as you want. And then let's see what happens. So we're going to get this up. Now, sometimes the experiments don't work. Because if I pour this over somebody's head, this is what's going to happen. Because we didn't do any experimenting. Before you do any of these experiments, when you've got chemicals that you don't know, you have to work it out beforehand. And that's what scientists do. So whenever you buy anything from anybody, you've had scientists have been experimenting. Now, what we've got here is a little cup. And I used 1 spoonful of those Death Eater crystals. Let's put that in there. And then using a very small pipette, I'm going to find out the amount of water that is needed. So I put a little squirt on there. A little squirt there. So I only needed the tiniest amount of water for that to be absorbed. If I put in too much water, because these aren't the same as the nappy crystals, it doesn't suck it up, and then you'll end up having water on top of your head or somebody else's head. But what is really nice about the jelly bath is the fact that it is slimy. Look at this. We don't get this with the nappy powder. And once you've done your magic, you can then play with the slime afterwards. Now there is lots and lots of science in slime. So that's what we're going to look at now. We're going to do a little bit of magic, clear the table, and come back again. 3, 2, 1. I'm back again. Now, when we were playing with that jelly bath, we noticed it was very, very, very stringy. And some of our molecules can be joined together to make long, long, long chains. And if we do that, we call them polymers. And a lot of the chemicals that are made up of long chains will have poly in the name. And so what I've got here is polyvinyl alcohol. It's a glue. And when I pour it, I'm going to stop pouring it, but you'll notice at the moment it's not pouring. But if I do this and then bring it up to the edge, it still comes over the edge. Those long chains pull it over. Oh, did I measure out the volume? No, such a bad scientist. Whenever we are measuring at home, though, there are lots of things that we have. Baby's bottles are fantastic measuring cylinders. And we get little medicine cups that we can use to measure as well. Got some elixir of life here. So this is going to be, this is my water. So I'm going to put in the same amount to glue. So we got half to half, and let's see what happens. Now, at the moment, the colour is quite boring. It's only white. So I'm going to use some foam for me to be able to colour it up. So I've got some blue foam. But this foam is magical. I've got liquid in there, liquid soap. But when I press this button, there's a canister of gas in here, a canister of butane gas. And it pushes the foam out really, really, really fast. And it forms really tiny bubbles. In fact, those bubbles are so small, I can actually bounce a solid. Now, what magic word could we use to get something to bounce? Bounce-yo? You can come up with your own magic words. So you can fill your hand with liquid and then you can bounce it. But we're going to bounce it into our glue. At the moment, it is just long, long, long threads, just like long snakes in a bowl. And I'm going to mix them up with my hand. It's very messy, this. There we go. Fantastic. I could put in some yellow foam as well. And, oh, what color would I get if I've got blue and yellow together? So again, lots of different science that we could move about. Now I'm going to put a little bit more glue in because that's feeling too runny for my liking. Oh, that's much better. Now, what I need to do is to get all of those long chains to connect. And this is where we need a magic wand. And I'm going to say, connectio! And they're all going to connect together. And they're going to connect together whenever I put in some of this special liquid. This is a slime activator. And if you think about Velcro and the hooks and the loops of Velcro, this is what this is going to be like. So it's going to go in, still looks like water. We're going to say our spell, Connectio! And let's see if anything weird happens. Oh my goodness. Look at this. Oh, I love this. And we have made a wonderful slippery slime. And I think all witches and wizards, they just love slime. Ogres love slime as well. This could actually end up being coming from an ogre's mouth, couldn't it? Go, achoo! Oh! They got the, oh, because humans make lots of slime as well. Whenever we've got the cold, all of that stuff that comes from our nose, is slime. And just like slime, if you treat it rough, it acts like a solid, just like that foam. So any slime, put big force on it, it breaks. But then if you treat it gently, it all flows together. So today we've been looking at polymers. Lovely science to do with polymers. I'm Scientific Sue. Thank you so much for joining me. Bye.